Now there's a way in Excel where you can number data automatically. So if you ever try to number information, so let's see, I've got information here. I want to number them. So normally people will just go 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and so on. I mean, if there's 1,000 lines, it can take forever. And now when somebody deletes one thing there, then it's out of sync. Or the other option which they do is that 1 plus 1, and they just copy that down. And the same problem, if I delete something in the middle, it gives me errors, then I have to copy down my formulas again. And what if I've got something like this, then this number is not right. So how do we do this automatically? Now, do you remember the formula called the count A? Let's recap it quickly. So if I do a count A formula, and I select this range, then it will tell me how many cells is not empty. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 6 cells not empty. So let's redo this a bit. If I do a count A there, and I only do the first 2 cells, then it's only going to find 1 cell that's not empty. If I do another one here, but now I just select the additional cell, it's going to give me a number 2. And I do another one there. So you could do the same formula everywhere, but let's be a bit smarter. If I fix the first one, because every time I go down, it always stays on B1. Can you see there, B1 always stays the same. So we can just fix it, and then we can copy down. And now, can you see the magic? Now it numbers it. Even if I delete something in the middle, it will just number it. So now we just have to make it a bit more pretty. How do we do that? Let's just put it in an if formula to say, if that cell is empty, then just give me a space, an empty cell again. Otherwise, do the count A formula. So, okay. And there you are. So now anywhere I can go and add numbers and it will automatically number my data for me. So that's how you number data automatically. The other way of numbering, so let's say for example, I've got the number A. I've got the number A there. In the middle, I've got the number B. Now I want to make cells unique because currently we've got, let's just see, we've got 8 A's, which is all exactly the same. So I would ideally like to number them from 1 to 8. And then I want to start with the B's and I want to start at 1 again and number them from 1 to 5. And then if I concatenate the number that I've did and the number that was the specific cell, then I've got a unique cell. So we can do this with a count if formula. So we use exactly the same principle as the count A, where we just fix the first one. And then I just search for the A. So there it will work. Why does it work? Because every single time when we go one down, the range increases. So effectively it will find an additional criteria. So now how do we make this unique? We just concatenate that and that, and now we've got a unique field. So let's test this. Let's put a conditional format where it says duplicate values. So then everything will be duplicate values. Let's do a conditional format there. Duplicate values. Then nothing is duplicate because now we've created unique cells. Now this principle is very important. And throughout this course, you'll see this principle a lot and see where you can use it and also see how powerful this really is. So I would really spend some time on understanding this because it's very, very powerful.